Dacrocelium dendriticum, also called the liver fluke, is a tiny parasite that uses ants to infect the only animals he can reproduce in, cows and sheep. When the fluke infects the ant, it takes control of the ant's movements. At night, the liver fluke forces the ant to climb on top of a blade of grass, where it stays fixed thanks to its mandibles. This behavior increases the probability that the ant will be accidentally eaten by a cow passing by, cow in which the fluke will be able to reproduce and spread. But that's not the only brain hacker. Have you already met those 10 to 70 centimeters long worms that we call nematomorpha? We find them close to watering holes, outdoor swimming pools or ponds that are perfect environments for adult worms. To reach those watering holes, nematomorpha take control of locusts and grasshoppers. But how? It's pretty easy. Once inside the locust, the worm will secrete proteins that will modify the activity of the locust's brain, forcing him to leap into the water every time it gets close to a pond or close to your swimming pool. This is when nematomorpha gets out of its host, who doesn't have long to live generally. Finally, what should we think of Toxoplasma gondii, this unicellular parasite known to give toxoplasmosis? This parasite can only reproduce in cats and uses mice to spread from cat to cat. Although mice usually tend to avoid cat smelly places, it has been shown that mice infected by Toxoplasma gondii lose this repulsion, or better, are attracted by this smell. In the end, infected mice have more chances to walk in places frequented by cats, and thus more chances to get caught by a cat, to Nematomorpha's great delight. All those animals are called parasites, because they can develop and reproduce at the expense of other organisms. Throughout evolution, those parasites have developed strategies, allowing them to use other intermediate species and modify their behavior to spread and join the species or medium in which they can reproduce. Could the same thing happen in humans? Could a parasite hack our brain? Well, the last parasite we've just seen, Toxoplasma gondii, can actually infect humans in addition to mice. And it is estimated that around one third of the world's population could be infected. Most of the time, they're harmless for humans, except for the fetus. But recent studies have shown associations of Toxoplasma gondii with affective and neurologic disorders. For example, there are correlations between the infection of Toxoplasma gondii and schizophrenia, and other more bizarre correlations like a high probability to get involved in two car crashes when we were infected. Though it is not yet possible to affirm that Toxoplasma gondii causes those behaviors, maybe the fact of being schizophrenic increases the chance to get infected by Toxoplasma gondii, it's a serious topic, especially regarding its abilities to manipulate mice. And maybe this could explain the strange phenomenon of cat ladies, those old women who like to own dozens of cats. What if Toxoplasma gondii was behind this?
Don't forget you can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you soon!